Padding is a CSS property that is used to generate space around HTML element and probably one of the most used property. But do you know that padding can be used for more than just adding space? In this tutorial, we will show you the CSS padding trick to create preserve aspect ratio element for responsive design. Ready? Let's check it out. So I have this box on a page with fixed size 4:3 aspect ratio. If we resize the browser window, the box will stay the same because the fixed size in pixels. This is not good for responsive design if we want the box to auto-resize. The simple solution is to define width and height as a relative value like percentage. This works fine for most of the time, but if you want the box to auto-resize and still maintaining the aspect ratio, then you will need to use padding. Simply set the height to 0 and add a percentage padding bottom, and that's it. Here's the secret. Percentage padding bottom is always based on the width of the container. And unlike margin, the space generated from padding are also considered part of that element. So if we set the height to 0 and use only padding to define the height of the element, we will be able to lock the aspect ratio. So if we want to create, let's say, element with 16:9 aspect ratio, we will need to set the padding bottom to the width multiplied by 9 and divide by 16. Now there is a minor problem with this method. Since all the height are generated with padding, all the content will be pushed to the top. So if we use a flex layout to vertically center the content, it won't work. To fix this, we will need to create a container inside to wrap the content. Then use absolute position to put it back into place. Then move the flex setting to the wrapper instead. We also need to set the relative position to the main box to support the absolute position of the child element. And now if we set the child element size to percentage, we'll also have the same aspect ratio with auto resize. And that's all for this video. If you want to see more development tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe this channel for weekly update. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Bye!